you may. There's something going on today. Looks like there's a lot of people out.
15th, 2023. Would you please join me in a minute of silence? Would you please join me and stand if you are able and join me in the pledge? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
All right. Class today will be fairly similar to last class, but I guess before we talk about the agenda here, if you did not turn in last class's factoring work, that was number 50. If you did not get that in Google Classroom before class, then I need your hard copy with your name on it if you want full credit on it. So if you need to double check that, then please do, but I need that at the start of class. So we've got a little bit split here, a little bit factoring, a little bit more working on the semester exam review. So the factoring part is completely optional. So this is totally just for the people who want to do it. But I have 10 factoring questions that I will put in the gradebook as a quiz. So you'll have to do it without notes, without your phone and stuff like that. But it is optional. So if you don't want to take it, you don't have to. But if you take it and you get 8 out of 10, you get 8 out of 10. It's not a let me see how it gets graded. So you need to be thinking about if you need or want those points to want to give that a shot. I'm fine with using a calculator on it though. And the other thing that's not optional is I'd like at least 10 more questions from the semester exam review, so that should put you at 25 completed questions, because I asked you to do 15 last time. The first 15 should be the easiest. If you're just picking off the ones that look the easiest, the next set should be a little bit harder, but that's why I'm asking you to do 10 instead of 15. So that gets a pretty good dent into that. So any questions about the agenda for today? Okay, again, I honestly have no preference with the optional quiz. It's certainly a lot easier on me to not have to grade a bunch of them. But if you would like to take the optional quiz, if you would raise your hand. Well, you need to clear off your desk. But
clear off your desk, raise your hand, and then we'll bring it to you unless you take it.
Up on the side of the wall, but do put them away, please. If you leave them on your desk, just out of habit, sometimes you guys will grab it and check it for a moment, and I don't know what you're looking at or how long you were looking at it, so I could not. I'd have to give you a zero on the quiz. So make sure your phone's put away until you have the quiz turned in. If you're choosing to do the quiz, you should probably number it as 51. If you're not doing the quiz, that's fine. Just, you will have a blank spot in number 51. If you keep up with like an index, like where you like to write what each thing is on the front, just make sure you put that it was optional. That would explain why you're missing it. I'll interrupt one more time and then I'll be quiet. I did have a meeting yesterday and they talked about semester exam exemption stuff. I don't think anybody in here had asked me when that would go out, but some of my other classes did. So when you guys come back from break, there will be a Google form for you to fill out, for you to say, these are the classes I'm hoping to exempt from. You'll submit that Google form. The office will go through and you'll have like a week, I think, from like Monday when you return to the next Monday to do that. They'll go in gradebook, see if you have too many unexcused absences in that class or advisory or too many tardies. Make sure that you don't have more than one major discipline referral. Make sure you don't have library fines, that kind of stuff. And then it'll get sent to your teachers. And then if you also have the grade requirement, then your teachers will give you the thumbs up that you are officially exempt. Of course, not all classes allow exemptions, so you need to talk to the teachers, or at least ask the teachers of the classes you're hoping to exempt from. But we do allow exemptions in here as long as you meet all the school requirements. The only additional requirement that we add to that is you will have to finish up the semester exam review. But even after today, you should have 25 out of 38 questions completed. So that should not be a big ask. Okay, now I'll be quiet. So again, even if you're not doing the optional quiz, please work quietly, independently until those are done. I will let you guys know when all the quizzes are in. And then just work at least 10 more from your semester exam review. course, you guys are welcome to do more than 10 on your semester exam review. There are two or three questions from section 5.3 that we won't do until after Thanksgiving break, so of course you don't need to go out of your way to try to figure those out. You can just wait on those. But basket, please. Thank you. Thank you.
I
Of the optional quizzes are finished. People who chose to do that. So you guys are welcome to work together or visit quietly while you work on the semester test review.
Again, please make sure that you have at least 25 questions completed on that before you call it quits for today.
You'll have to do all of it eventually, so if you have time to do more than that, that's great. But if you don't have at least 25 done by the end of class, then you need to do that for homework. Also, on Friday, I suspect quite a few people will not be here on Friday. So Friday will be basically more of the same, where you'll have an extra day, one more day to work on the semester test review. I will remind you, I guess I'll just give you the reminder now, but I'll give you the reminder on Friday as well. On the top of the review, it lets you know that you can use a calculator on the entire final exam, that you can use a 3-inch by 5-inch note card, but only one side, and it has to be handwritten. So especially as you guys get into questions that are less familiar to you or more difficult to you, you should probably be adding stuff to a separate sheet of paper, whether that's unit circle, sample questions, identities, the range of inverse trig functions, anything that we have would benefit you on a note card, I would put on a separate sheet of paper. Then when it comes time for the final, the night before, you can copy over the stuff that you need to a note card. So I will encourage students to do that on
Friday. When we come back from Thanksgiving break, there is just 12 classes, which means you'll see each of your classes 6 times, and then it's final exams. So you guys are getting one extra day before the break. So there will be a day where you can ask questions and such, although you guys are welcome to ask questions today too, but there'll be one full day set aside to help refresh you on anything you'd like to be refreshed on. But we'll worry about that when it's closer to the final time. But again, even if you think you're exempting, first off, you don't know if you're going to meet the requirements until it's official, but we also require you to finish the review. So don't not do the review thinking that you don't need to because you plan on exempting it. Okay, otherwise, that's all I've got for you today. And again, that's the plan on Friday. So after Friday, you should be pretty close to finished with the semester test review. Again, there's a couple questions we haven't talked about, so it totally makes sense that you may not know how to do those. But by the end of class on Friday, you should at least have basically everything done that we have taught, minus maybe a couple questions that you don't remember how to do. When we come back from break, we'll spend a couple class periods finishing up that last section, 5.3. That's the one that's going to need some factoring, which is why we've been practicing that. And then we'll do a day for semester test review, and then it'll be time for your semester test. And that'll be it. I do have the optional quizzes graded today, but I would like to not pass those back yet. I'm going to use the same quiz for my other two pre-cal classes, so you are welcome to have yours back on Friday, though, if you are here on Friday. Otherwise, you can get it after break if you want it. Someone has an emergency. I've got a backup pass. Yes, please. I just need to know who has my pass in case they didn't come back. Thank you.
Okay, I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but your advisor hopefully did. We will have an intruder drill this morning. And this year they're not sharing exact times with us, but
somebody just told me that it would be at 9:30. So
in a few minutes, I don't know if they're going to tell you that it's just a drill, so I wanted to warn you ahead of time so you didn't panic or anything. But we'll have to make sure the door's locked, turn off the lights, and you'll have to get somewhere up to the front of the room. So you'll have to sit up here for a few minutes.
Just a heads up.